All right, people. I think we've only got a minute or two before our friends out there start playing not so nice.
And our weapons?
We're good to go on this end, boss. Let's see what the bishop can do.
Before he heads for the guns, I've got an idea. Can you patch me into the F-35s?
No problem. You're on.
Pilots are threatening homeless mercenaries. I am Knight 15, commanding officer of the consortium vessel, Zenlil. In an effort to seize control of this vessel, your leader has been captured by our bishop. In exchange for lenient jail time, Angeloth is telling us your names, where you live, where your family members live, anything we want to know. If you do not wish to have an enemy in the consortium for the rest of your lives, disengage immediately.
That should do it.
Wade, do me a favor and fire a couple of shots across a few of their bows. Give them a little scare.
You've got it. A few already tacking off, boss. And listen to this.
There's no hope here. Angelov has betrayed us. They're not disabled and not too powerful. We must retreat.
The rest not running off for home are beginning attack patterns. It looks like we've got ourselves a good old-fashioned dogfight. Bishop, I need you on the guns right away.
You can access the manual weapons system through the command interface inside mission operations.
Alright, let's do this.
Alright, so this is Zen's manual weapons control interface. Now let's get this thing done. Quick crash course before I let you at it. Your left control can lock and release non-lethal EMP tip missiles. Aim the cursor, then press and hold to lock onto a target. Once a lock's been made, the missile will fire on its own and harmlessly swat your target from the sky. Your right control is Zen's point defense laser. It's most useful for destroying incoming missiles. But that bad boy can also obliterate fighters in an instant, killing the pilot. So try not to take it there unless absolutely necessary.
Get out of there, missile. Flawless victory, I think.
Oh, bloody hell, B.
That was incredible. In my 5 years with the consortium, I have never seen anyone handle themselves like that with our weapons.
I second that, and I'm starting to see a little why the king likes you so much.
And six, now that everyone knows, I want you to start an internal investigation into the murder of Pawn 7. Just ask around a little, but don't push too hard. I'll be in global office with my head in my own work.
Speak with the crew about Pawn 7's murder. Okay, so. Discover who the traitor is. Yeah, that's the objective that, on my first playthrough, I failed. But now, I know who it is. And if knowing who it is in advance doesn't allow me to solve the case, then I suck. Let's make a save here. Right. So it is Patricia who is... Which one is she? Pawn 32, which I better write down just in case. Just in case I get into a situation where I can't look at this and I forget who she is, what her number is. So let's focus on Pawn 32. If I can ask anybody about her, I'm going to.
So I hear Knight 15 wants you asking around about Matt's so-called murder. Are you here to grill me?
Like a steak. Well, I know she didn't do it, so I guess I'll just say no, you couldn't have done it.
Well, yeah, isn't that pretty much a given? I've been here the whole time, ever since I saw you by your cabin earlier. Pawn 7 was apparently killed after that.
Hmm. Who told you I was asked to investigate?
It doesn't matter, does it? News spreads fast around.
Have you got a second?
Someone must have told someone.
Come in. Come in.
Well, it was great talking to you.
Hold on. See how long it takes him to close this. Wade. 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 He just doesn't care. He does not care at all. Okay. Oh shit, we're having a conversation. Aww. I have no idea what she was saying. Does he really not notice I'm here? That's strange.
Hello, Bishop.
I can't even talk to him. Forget the elevator.
Yes, Bishop. Why don't you sit down and we can talk? I'm sure Pontifex. Bravo. Good man. So what can I help you with?
Can I actually play chess with him? That'd be neat. Well, I'm sure you've heard about Pawn 7 by now. Actually, don't forget, I'm going to talk about chess. Do you play chess often?
I try to, yeah. And so does Pawn 51. Kura and I began a game last night, and I'm rather eager to beat her into next week.
Can I ask you about Pawn 7?
Yes, sir. We all have. Terribly unfortunate business. But let's first wait until Kendra gets back before we discuss that.
Okay. Nice talk.
I'm coming.
Kendra. I truly hope that everything is okay.
Everything's fine. Now it is, at least.
Hey, are you ready to experience how tables can be turned?
You're dreaming, old man. Now, let's see. Was it my move?
Yes, it was. And please, take your time.
Hey, Bishop. That was some pretty amazing work with Angelov. With 283 separate recorded incidents under his belt, it was about time someone put him behind bars.
That damned computer brain of yours.
Yeah, well, it's a mixed blessing when it only allows for 1,533 hours of sleep a year.
That is not very much, Bishop, if you were wondering. So I'm told the Bishop here has been tasked with investigating Pawn 7. I'm assuming he has some questions you'd like to ask us, don't you, Bishop?
Really? Let's get it over with then. Ask away.
Once again, I know you two had nothing to do with it. What do you know or think about Pawn 7's death?
The truth? There have been 2,952 operations since the Consortium was first formed, and this is the first time a murder has occurred aboard a C-3800. Not to mention the first time one's been EMP'd, boarded, and shot up. Today has been nothing short of insane. That's what I think.
Neither of us have left global operations since this morning. As you may have noticed, things have been a little crazy around here.
Okay, well, that settles it then, doesn't it?
Maybe talk to Rook 25, Pawn 32, or Pawn 4. They were all working with Pawn 7 this morning in the hangar bay.
Do you think one of them could be responsible?
I have a hard time thinking anyone aboard this vessel could be responsible. But to be entirely honest, I don't know Pawn 4 all too well. And he's sort of a dink.
He really is, isn't he?
So you've met him. Yes, he's found a way of getting on everyone's nerves. But it's more of an ego-tripping problem, not so much a murderous traitor problem, you know?
I don't see killer in him. I only see single for life.
He's definitely a handful.
So what about Rook 25 or Pawn 32?
Well, Rook 25 is a bit of a loose cannon, but there's no way she had anything to do with this.
Wait a second. Why in the hell is the Knight of 15 giving you the task of interrogating her crew anyway? It does not seem right, does it? I mean, you barely know any of us.
That's precisely why I'm the right choice.
All right, both of you. Just stop it. This won't get us anywhere, and I think the bottom line is simple. Bishop, neither of us had anything to do with what happened to Pawn 7. End of conversation.
All right, well, come on then, Kendra. Make your move.
I am sorry, Bishop, but I guess we can't talk any longer. I need to put an old man in his place.
Poor Kovac. How come I didn't see that?
I honestly have no idea. And please, take your time.
Come on, guys. We've got another 4 million tasks to complete when this is done.
Oh, no. Oh, not a chance. You get the hell away from me.
Hell no.
Stop it. Go away.
Nope.
What don't you understand? Pawn 7 is dead because of you, and I don't want to be next.
Before we get to Pawn 7, did you tell Pawn 19 I was investigating Pawn 7's murder?
Did I? What? Who cares, Bishop? The whole ship knows that by now. I want you to go away. Don't you understand English, or... or is my accent just not American enough for you?
Okay, I believe you.
I'm so very pleased.
You're welcome.
This. Now, scram before I get the broom.
God, I wish there were more dialogue options for him.
Oh, for Christ's sake, what? I had nothing to do with Matthew's death, if that's what you're still pestering me about.
Oh, there are more options. Sweet. What is wrong with you?
You are! Have I not been clear enough on this point? Pawn 7's death, Angelo showing up like he did, these glitches all over the ship, I drop a million euro bucks that you are the direct reason for all of it.
How can you blame me for doing nothing wrong?
Blaming you? No, I'm not blaming you. I just don't want to be anywhere near you when the next maniac shows up. I truly hope you're satisfied because I'm done talking. I don't use the P word that often, but will you please leave me alone now?
Farewell, my lovely. I wonder what it was like for authors in 1940.
What did she just say?
Farewell, my lovely. You should pick it up sometime. You know, when you're not investigating this murder.
What the fuck?
Don't come any closer.
I'm gonna come really close. I'm touching. Okay. Farewell, my love. Is he trying to give me a hint? What is Farewell, My Lovely? I could search the computer banks for it. It made it sound like it was a book. It says something about 1940. Farewell, My Lovely. I'm gonna write it down. Alright. There's a note I just wrote that is so illegibly scrawled that I probably won't even be able to read it in 5 minutes. You know, let me see if I can figure out what it is before I talk to Patricia.
Puta, damn you.
She's in such a weird pose there. She was last time. It looks painful for her back. Super jump.
Hey, Bishop, have you tried the chicken today? It's damn good!
No, I have not. Pawn 44.
If you're here to question my people, wait for them to finish. If you're here to question me, do it later.
Question us? Come now, Bishop. There is really no need.
Adele, how's your back feeling after the 200 shots you took in it? I'm not here for that.
It doesn't really matter, does it? Hold first, then you can chit-chat until hell freezes over.
Other problem. Hold first, chit-chat later.
And Bishop, we could really use some help around here with all of these repairs.
Sorry,
Let
Bishop.
Me know when you have
I know minute. You're busy, but I would appreciate it if you'd stop by Global Ops for just a few minutes. The Queen would like to speak with you. There's no immediate rush, whenever you're able.
Noted.
So, are you here to help, or just wandering aimlessly?
You want to put me to work, don't you?
That's about right. It shouldn't take long. What do you say?
Sure, just tell me what to do.
Good. We can use the help. Go ahead and access the chip locker over there, by the brig. I've unlocked it for you, and you're going to need a stack of fresh data chips. And you too. I want this done by the time I get back. In other words, I want you out of here and back to work elsewhere.
Roger that. Consider it done.
Meshku.
Well now, what the heck does that mean?
Oh, nothing.
Since you skillfully smashed those F-35s all over Bulgaria, the damage to Zenlil is minimal and you won't need too many chips. Grab a bunch, then head up to Upper Avionics and the Upper Crawl. If you need more, you can always come back.
I'm just gonna drop them. I'll just recycle them. Okay. That should be enough. There we go. 64, 64, 64, 64. I can talk to him.
Hold on a second. I think we're about finished here.
Yep, just one more. Bingo! And that, as they say, is all she wrote.
All who wrote?
Never mind. I think we did good work here. Rook 9 should be happier than a wirehead on Black Friday.
Yes, yes. Well done to us. So, Bishop, I suppose you'd like to now know who we think is responsible for Pawn 7. Rook 25 did say you've been tasked to speak with us, yes?
I will not need you, but thank you, sir.
Do either of you know who the killer may be?
Wait, you don't actually believe one of us is some kind of killer? It's impossible! I'm still on the camp that Rook 13 is wrong. There's no other reasonable explanation.
I have a hard time thinking that Mr. Excon Procedure is ever wrong about anything.
I'm just gonna say nothing. Make a super awkward conversation.
It is not us you want to look at anyway. Try Pawn 64. If I had to choose someone, it is him.
Wait a second, you don't know that. He is a friend of mine, and I know he could never do it. Never. No way, not a chance. I know people, Adele, and I know you're wrong.
Maybe you're not the best judge of character after all.
So he's got something personal going on that he'd rather not talk about. It doesn't make him a killer.
I am not accusing anyone, but he has been acting unusual.
I'm stuck.
Distant.
I'm
racist.
Literally stuck.
Something has him frightened. Maybe Pawn 7 caught 64 doing something he should not have been doing.
It's a human
like
sandwich.
Maybe he was contacting Angelov.
You have some extraordinarily bad
I don't
time.
Want to be the filling. Get me out of here.
What are you... Oh, Mel. He is behind me, isn't he?
Unfortunately, yes.
Hi.
Go ahead. Wait, yes. Okay? No problem. I'm on it. Well, duty calls. Did I get that one right, Charlie? Duty calls?
Haha, perfect! And yeah, I should probably get back to work as well. Lots to do.
Please move.
Take care, Bishop. And watch your back.
You watch your back. You took 200 shots in the back of it. Please move.
Don't let her bother you. She's all right.
Please move.
She thinks I killed Pawn 7 and helped Angelo. She is not all right.
Nobody actually believes that. Don't be ridiculous. She was just blowing off some steam, releasing some of that tension we're all feeling today.
I know you don't believe it, my friend. And I understand I haven't been myself lately. But I promise you, have nothing to worry about. Okay?
Well, all right. But if I have nothing to worry about, then you stop being so grumpy. It doesn't suit you.
I don't suppose you want to tell me what else they said.
You heard enough. Pawn 11 thinks you're guilty.
Aye. I really don't think she likes me very much.
She's still here. She's right behind me. You can see her if you move your eyes 2 inches to the left.
It doesn't matter. She's only afraid.
I think it does matter. Do you think she'll speak to anyone else? Knight 15, Rook 25 maybe. I only need to stay off their radar a little while longer.
I can protect you, just tell me the truth.
Maybe you can, maybe not. And I'm not ready to talk just yet.
Okay, so look, Bishop. I'm sorry, but for now, just keep away from me, please.
Oh, thank God I can move. Oh.
Let's follow him, silently.
Ooh, checkmate. Alright, what's the name of these books? Blood Crazy. I'm looking for Farewell, My Lovely. Nope. You're looking at the information console. Alright, so what am I doing? I've got a lot of things to do, actually. What is Farewell, My Lovely? I need to repair the stuff. Let's look at the information console. Breaking news, I've already read them last time. I guess I'll just get rid of them. There we go. So, Farewell, My... Doesn't allow spaces. It's a futuristic search engine that does not allow spaces. Nor does it allow you to press enter. Farewell. There we go. Farewell, My Lovely, and A Hand at Fiction. Okay. By the Consortium King. A Newswire exclusive. Holy shit, that's long. Okay, I'm gonna skim that in just a second. I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back. So let's skim this. Normally I read all notes, but I don't think I have the patience to read all of that. Alright, by the Consortium King. After a little while, I felt a little better. But very little. I needed a drink. I needed a lot of life insurance. I needed a vacation. I needed a home in the country. What I had was a coat, a hat, and a gun. I put them on and went out of the room. Farewell, My Lovely by Raymond Chandler, October 1st, 1940. He mentioned the year 1940. I don't remember exactly what he was saying about it, but he said 1940. I've always been fascinated by literature. When I was first brought online, though I prefer to call it being born, even if I wasn't, right, so this is the king, who is an artificial intelligence. Read hundreds of thousands of books over the course of the last few years. Some I read in milliseconds, others at a leisurely pace in the same way a human would. While I cannot truly curl up on a chair before a roaring fire on a windswept stormy night in a dark mansion by the sea, I do my best to appreciate them in the manner they were created. Several genres have caught my attention over the years, and one of them was the noir detective stories of the 1930s and 40s. Wait a minute. Hold on. So one of those genres the king is infatuated with is noir detective stories. Now this game that I'm playing right now is not exactly noir in any way. But it is a detective story. Is this the AI's attempt at writing? Making this game? I decided I wanted to try my hand at it. First step was to take one of the true classics and study it in depth. And the king chose Farewell, My Lovely by Raymond Chandler. For your enjoyment, I present to you the first part of my first novel, set in the traditional film noir format with a small twist. Chicago Haven, A Case File of Henry Chard, Private Eye, Part 1, A Case, but with nothing but trouble. It's amazing the amount of detail they put into this game, really. I should sit down at some point and just read this stuff. I might, at some point. Not right now, though. Alright, trains and coats and jobs. Alright. I walked up and wrote down the number, 803. I wonder if that's relevant at all. Room 803, I said into the silence. Nothing. 803. I'm gonna write that down just in case it's relevant. Walked around to room 803. Whoa. Wait a minute. There's some familiarity here. There's some similarities here to the case that just happened. Look. Let's see. The 8th floor was silent when I got off the elevator. I walked around to room 803. The door was closed, and there were no signs of a break-in. Okay, just like when I went into the room of the murdered guy, just now. I placed my hand, and tried to turn the knob. It turned. Hell. This feeling in my gut hammered. Something was going on here. I stepped into the room, pitch black. Just like what I just experienced, except for the illumination from neon down the street. I felt like I should be holding a gun, if I could afford one. I'd pawned the damn thing I'd brought back from the war last year. The bed was made, and there were no signs that anyone was even staying here, no luggage, no suits. Hell, the mint was still in the pillow. The only out-of-place thing was that the bathroom door was shut tight. I nearly leapt out of my skin when a white flash came from under the bathroom door, followed by a low moan. I walked to the door and went inside. Haven lay in the bathtub, and he looked like he'd been shot 6 times in the gut. There was blood everywhere. Although he was still alive but unconscious, huh? Whoa, looks like it's turning sci-fi. The weird organic growth was attached to me and crept up into my arm. What the hell? Wait a minute, what the fuck? Everything spun and I pitched forward down as blackness took me. It was right after I just turned sci-fi, some sort of light taking him over. I'm not sure what time it was when I woke up. Haven was still in the bathtub and it was night outside. I was laying on my back on the tile and I hurt like I'd been worked over by a team of thugs. Everything was out of focus. That's exactly how it was when I woke up. New user recognized. Across my eyes. The hell? Wait. That was in English. Those characters were something. I saw them as English, but adjusting settings. Pain, like an ice pick in my brain. Setup complete. Run, they're coming for you. I stood up, the words kept flashing at the bottom of my vision. Run, they're coming for you. Run, they're coming for you. Run, they're coming for you. I dragged my vision away from the words. I heard angry voices from the hallway and looked out the people. The men in suits from the weird-looking car were there, with the bellboy. They were arguing less than a foot from the door. They wanted in, but he wasn't. One of the men raised what looked like a gun and shot the bellboy. The poor bastard just blew apart. What landed looked a lot like what was left of Haven in the bathtub behind me. The man in the suit raised the gun and pointed it right at the door. Right at me. Oh shit. To be continued, what the hell? This has some similarities to what's going on with me now. Oh, Jesus. Hi.
Were you watching me?
So So wait a minute, if I just read that, how come this doesn't didn't update? Discover what is farewell, my lovely. I just did. Is this related? Why does this show up? 4 of 21. Danielle? Amara? If this doesn't count as figuring out what it is, then what does? Maybe it has been continued? What's the name of the story? Let me see if we can find the other part. I'm not sure which part of this is the name. Or even if any of this is the name. Chicago Haven? A case file of Henry Chard Private Eyes? I can't even put a space in here, though. I can only search for one term. Part 2? I can't even type numbers. I can't even press enter. Oh my god. Huh. Maybe I can ask somebody about it. You kind of creep me out, Adele. Anyway, what the hell was I doing? Oh yeah, I also wanted to look up, the resource war. Nice spelling. There we go. Death of the modern military. Oh, here we go, the resource wars. See if there's anything else here. Probably the best one. Alright. Not too long either. Not sure if I'm going to read the whole thing, but let's see. An excerpt from the novel The Resource Wars, A Feud of Futility. The Early Wars, Fighting Over Bones. Okay. In 2014, due to the rapid industrialization and widening of the middle class in China, oil consumption was at an all-time high. Even though many variations of the electric car were now hitting the markets across Europe and North America, it was a status symbol in China to have a gas-guzzling metal beast. A fad that was not unsimilar to what was seen in the 1980s and 90s in urban America. Though ironically aided by China's failed anti-car laws. Due to millions of new cars being left on the road, and with a global turn against nuclear power plants, it became apparent to analysts that the global oil reserves were not going to last. Okay. The truth is that many industries simply did not want to pay the hundreds of millions or even billions to switch to green energy. Mining companies in British Columbia and Russia continued to use gigantic gas-fueled drills and delving equipment. While the first military strike at the resource wars happened in Libya, the true economic wars had started years beforehand. The idea of major power countries going to war with each other had been taught by many as part of history, as economic and debt-based ties meant that each nation was tied to each other. China held much of the US's debt, for example. If open hostilities began, and if the US then defaulted on these loans, the Chinese economy would collapse overnight. Mm-hmm. Tariffs and restrictions on goods began to pop up. It wasn't long before many European countries began to impose such tariffs on goods that they felt were being imported at too high a price. On goods they felt were being imported at too high a price. At the beginning of the war, it was mostly textile and commercial electronics. So come around 2015, early developed nations began a campaign warning their citizens of the dangers of extreme energy and gas usage. North Korea attacked Libya for their natural oil reserves. To say it caused a domino effect would be to vastly underestimate the issue, or understate the issue. All right. There are simply too many people and too much power in too few people's hands. The resource wars were inevitable. That does make sense. And it's disturbing to think that that might, that, like, could actually happen in the real world. Definitely could. I really do want to clear this, the discover what is farewell my lovely, before I talk to Patricia, because it might be relevant. I'm not sure if he's trying to give me a hint as to who it is or what. Oh, that's to do the queen thing. Let's not do that yet. But I'm not sure how to clear that. I mean, I already read the article. I thought that would have been enough. Apparently it's not.
Nah. Sorry, Bishop. Can't talk. Too much to do. Why don't you head over to those busted chip banks, hmm? Upper Crawl and Upper Avionics. Get going.
All right, let's go ahead and do that. It's really weird how people just put junk inside of these tubes. Doesn't seem like a good idea to me. Okay, crawl space. Crawl spaces. Which ones? Which ones? Well, I guess I can just go up here. Whoops. Lights, please. There we go. Now, whenever the mission comes up to search for the bugs in the system to help Wade out, I need to do it, because last time I failed that mission as well.
Hey, so while you're doing that, why don't you ask me about Pawn 7? The K told you to question everyone.
Alright, what can you tell me?
I can tell you that if I didn't let him break for lunch, he'd still be alive right now. I can also tell you that once I find them, whoever is responsible will never see daylight again. Pawn 7 was a good kid. A bit of a pain in the arse, sometimes, but most of these kids are.
So you and him didn't get along?
It's not my job to get along with anyone on this plane. Pawn 7 and I disagreed on many things, and that I will take to the grave with regret. I certainly could have been nicer to him.
Well, I can say it's okay, you're not to blame. I know what that leads to. She snaps at me, but then I can say something else that makes her... Yeah. Or I can just say nothing. I'll just say nothing.
And with that, I'll leave you to it. I'm sure you don't need me talking in your head all day. Oh, hey. I just noticed you finished the job while we were talking. Thanks, Bishop. It was a tough job, but it looks like you pulled it off.
Wow, she wasn't... Kind of insulting. She didn't give me a backhanded compliment like she did last time. That's nice. Discover what is farewell, my lovely. I think I've already done that. I don't understand why that's still there. Is there anyone who would know about that book other than the guy who mentioned it to begin with, which I can't talk to again? What about the doctor? I don't know if he would know anything about books in particular. Let's go speak with him. Hmm. Creepy noises starting up.
We've almost got them all. Just take it easy.
This machine, it sort of makes me nervous. Oh, and hey, Bishop.
Everything, it seems, makes you nervous.
What's that supposed to mean? Are you saying you think I killed Pawn 7? Because I didn't have anything to do with that. I was in mission ops the whole time. Ask anyone, really, anyone at all.
Maybe we should sedate him.
No, Kieran. Bad Kieran. Just take it easy, okay?
I love that she talks to him like a dog. No, Kieran. Bad Kieran.
I'm sorry. It doesn't matter. So, Bishop, thanks for coming to see me. I'm just, you know, getting these huge fragments taken out of me. The doc here says those experimental bullets should have blown me to bits. It didn't hurt at all. Nope, not one bit. Not at all. Nope, no. No siree, no. Have you ever been shot before, Bishop? I'll bet you have.
Well, while I'm here, Bond 12... can you get me some coffee? I don't get shot.
So, you're saying that you just took on a boarding party, armed mercenaries, and you never took a single bullet?
Mm-hmm.
Well, I believe it. We've got a real special one on our hands here. I can feel it in my bones. Big things are ahead for you and me. I mean all of us. Big things ahead.
Is there something wrong with your vocal cords? They seem to vibrate far too often, and at an incredible rate.
I was going to tell him to stop drooling on the bishop, but yours is better.
Haha, real funny, guys. Thanks a lot. So, Doc, are we done here? I'd like to head back to Mission Ops, see if Rook 9 or Pawn 19 need my help.
Stop calling me Doc. The remaining bullet fragments have been removed, and the nanites forcibly flushed from your system, as requested. So yes, Pawn 12, we are done here. Can you please tell Pawn 1 that we are ready for him?
Yep, sure. Of course. Hey, Gary. Looks like you're up. It doesn't hurt. Really, it doesn't. I didn't feel a thing, and I was expecting to feel so much pain.
Be quiet, 12. Please.
Sorry.
Not now.
Well, if you want to come talk, Bishop, come see me in Mission Ops. Whatever.
Hey, Number 1.
I think it's so. Number 1.
Oh, God, this again.
You have the bridge, Number 1.
Please, guys. Yeah, for the 10th time, I get it. Just like Riker. Ha ha. My head is killing me, and I'm grumpy as hell.
Oh god, it's doing the crazy subtitle thing again.
So I can go lay down?
Or is it replicating?
Sorry, you're right.
Lay down here, and try to relax.
If you find cancer or something, I don't want to know about it. How long is this going to take?
Almost there. Just let it work.
And hey, Bishop. thanks for saving my life.
Touching, cowboy. Touching.
What is that supposed to mean?
Alan Rickman.
Who?
Never mind.
Okay, there we go. All done.
My head still feels like it's splitting in half.
That is to be expected, considering your injuries. I will inform Rook 25 that you will be taking the afternoon off.
Thanks. Oh, and Bishop, you'll have to speak with me tomorrow if you want to ask about Pawn 7. I really need to lay down.
Take care of yourself, Gary.
Yeah, I'll try.
We both need to concentrate, Bishop.
I guess the Bishop saving your life hasn't done much to improve your personality?
I'll just say nothing.
I take it you'd like to talk about Pawn 7.
It doesn't matter. You guys are clear.
Bishop? Rook 25 said to expect questions from you about Pawn 7.
Yeah, it's fine. Don't worry. Don't be silly. There'll be no questions.
Okay. Maybe later then.
So... Pawn 24 and I need to concentrate, and you have orders.
We need to concentrate on what, exactly?
Our work.
Right, our work, of course. Sorry, Bishop, but we apparently have work to do. So much work.
And back to Command VR for her. Okay, I talked to him about the book. Not sure what to do about that. Well, let's try that again. Lovely. Very well, my lovely. Mm-hmm. What the fuck is this? Explosificate. What? Regarding... Spam? What the fuck is this? Johnny, I want you to take a look at this message that has been flooding orbital communications for the last week. What? The hell is that? It's weird. Right. Well, not sure what to do with my information about the book. Yeah, let's just go speak to Patricia. Let's just go talk to Patricia.
Oh, hello, Bishop. I can't help but feel terrible about Point 7. He was a good kid. One of the best.
I must say, though, I am glad to see you're still with us after everything earlier. Someone sure has your number, don't they?
You could say that.
Do you have any idea why that pirate would do what he's done? Why he wanted to kill you?
How do you know he wanted to kill me?
I think everyone knows you were the target. You can thank Paul 19 for that. But you can never trust what Angelov says. Ever.
That's very observant of you. You should be a rook.
You really think so? I mean, I've thought about it. I guess every pawn has. Perhaps I could be a weapons and combat specialist, like Rook 25.
Mm-hmm. We could tell it was sarcasm. No. Well, I'm sure you'd be great at it.
Yeah?
Whoa, what the...
Well, hey.
The hell?
Thank you.
What the... What? Okay, we need to talk about something else. There's a bigger issue here. The issue of you being some sort of a teleporting entity? No, I need to ask you about Pawn 7.
Yes, I know. I understand. The only time I've left this room was when I went to Upper Avionics for a few minutes. I went through the third level, access from Global Ops, nowhere near the cabins.
What are your thoughts about Rook 25?
I know what you're thinking, Bishop. But no. I mean, it is ridiculous. She may have wanted to at times, but Rook 25 did not kill Pawn 7.
I only want to know what you think of her.
Well, we all know Pawn 4 doesn't like her at all. But I think she is an excellent boss.
What makes her so excellent?
She is honest and does not take crap from anybody. I respect that immensely.
Pawn 32, come here for a second. And Bishop, you can flirt with her later.
Just give me 2 minutes.
Oh, leave that stupid thing. It'll still be broken when you get back.
If you'll excuse me. Work is never complete for a lady with these assets.
With these
coming,
assets? The way she said that was strange.
So,
Next on the let's give thanks to Kirill Angelov repair list is to manually reboot and diagnose the atmospheric shielding. Wade says he's prepped it for a diaper change, and I hope you're up for the job.
I have a one-year-old niece, remember? I think I can handle it.
Good. And don't let the bishop or anyone else distract you. I don't care what they want.
No problem.
So that's all I can say to her. How do I discover who the traitor is? I wonder if it comes down to who you... Like, there's a section. Right before, when you're just going into VR, if you're going to sleep. Right before the traitor comes out. And tries to stop you. And it's Rook 25. And she says, do you have any hunches? Is there anyone you want me to keep an eye on? I wonder if that's what it comes down to solve that. Is telling her the right person. Wait a minute, I actually can talk to her again?
Sorry, nope, I can't talk. I need to concentrate.
Aww.
Nah, sorry, Bishop, can't talk. Too much to do.
Just seeing if there's anything else I could do to help?
You can find out who killed Pawn 7. That would be nice. But don't tell Decay if you do discover someone. You come to me first. Now get going.
Okay, well, what if I told you I know exactly who it is? Unfortunately, I can. So I'm in the awkward position of having to tell my character that I know who it is. How do I communicate that to my character? Was this save 5? I hope so. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah.
Bishop, if you have another minute, I wanted to ask you one more thing.
Oh yeah, it's about the church. Sure, what's on your mind?
It is about the Guardian Church. I was only wondering what your affiliation is, if any. Are you a member?
Thing is, I'm a seeker. And the church want me dead. We're kind of opposed. I'm basically the king's pawn. And the church doesn't like the king. Let's lie. Let's see what happens. Yes, I am.
That is all I wish to know. Perhaps we can attend a headway meeting together sometime. I suppose then I will let you return to work. I truly hope that you and I can become friends.
Of course. Of course. Not sure where that's gonna go now that I've just lied, but that should be interesting. This thing's gonna drive me crazy. What is farewell, my lovely? You know, maybe I just can't complete that now. I don't know. Alright, should we go speak to the Queen? Actually, let's see if we can go speak to Wade.
Ouch! Damn it, Zen! Don't touch it there, I get it. Blimey.
Stop that, Wade!
Blimey. I'm down at Lower Avionics trying to repair this bloody ship's automated defenses. And big surprise, she isn't cooperating. Oh, and I can't unlock the hatch, so don't ask. Safety protocols and all that. Ow! And if she doesn't start cooperating, I'm gonna pour drink all over her main board.
I love you too, Wayne.
Anyway, try not to get your kitty snort all over my buttons and switches. And stay out of my chair.
Oh yeah, sure, sure. Wade's throne of infinite comfort.
Hey now, did I say you could sit in my throne? Well, since you're already sitting, how'd you like it? Pretty comfy, isn't it?
Like sitting on a piece of heaven.
Well, if heaven is made of Canadian hemp and velvet, and it probably is, then yeah.
Nah, come on, Zen. Stop doing that.
How about We pretend like you never saw that, okay? Oh boy, God. I can't believe I left it on. And if the boss ever finds out you did see it, she'll likely kill us both. So between us, yeah? And do your best not to touch anything else. You're likely to crush the bloody plane with your luck.
I'm torn between wanting to do what I did before and wanting to do something completely different. Even if I don't like the options. Let's go with what I did before here. So you and Knight 15, huh?
No, B. There's nothing going on between us. That video was filmed over a year ago and was, well, it was after a particularly difficult day and a few glasses of wine.
Well, you two certainly are graceful together.
I like to think so. Again, though, that video stays between us, yeah?
Of course. My lips are sealed.
Good to hear, because really, I wasn't kidding. She'll kill us and toss us from an airlock. All right, well, back to work. If I don't get this thing fixed soon, I'll be in a world of hurt when another Angeloff decides to drop in and say hi. And these bloody glitches sure aren't making things any easier.
Don't you think it could be a virus?
A virus? No. More likely it's a software bug from my last repair. My girl would pick up an honest-to-God virus. Sensors would be going off all over the place. As it stands, the sensors are showing seemingly random fluctuations in very minor systems.
Maybe someone wants you to think it's only a bug.
I haven't left the cockpit all day. Oh Christ, could be spiking the cockpit, blocking me out. Of course. I've been so preoccupied, I should have thought of that.
Maybe I can do something to help.
Oh, did I hear that right? A bishop aiming to be helpful? Well, it's certainly a relief to know you're not all ego-driven hotheads. So, all I want you to do is observe instances of this so-called virus. When you see something, let me know of the CMC. Show me, I don't know, 5 different particularly bad examples. And hey, have fun!
Alright, so this is the quest that I ignored at first, and it resulted in something very bad happening to Wade. So this time I'm going to do it right now. I'm going to give it my complete attention. Before I even talk to the Queen. Alright, so 5 examples, right? Yep, 5 instances of broken Zenlil systems. Zenlil systems. Just look for weird stuff. Hi. I wish you could just mention the freaking creepy voices, but I guess that doesn't count. Whoa, what the f... Oh, that's one example. Does this fit the bill?
Yeah, it does. I'll let everyone know to stay away from those.
Oh my god! Don't crush me!
Just 4 more to go and we'll get to the bottom of this.
A spare uniform doesn't need to be here. Yoink! Guess the lights don't count. Alright, 4 more. 4 more. Ground for weird.
Hey there, Bishop.
Hello. She is positively cheerful about me. Which is funny, because I know she's the murderer. In fact, what is her alignment towards me? Huh. 7. She actually likes me a lot. Wonderful. The murderer loves me. Good for creepy stuff. Four more. Crap. Probably nothing in here. Nah. I'm seeing a lot of instances of weird stuff. Four. I need four more. It's weird. I get connection errors while I'm reading the book. Should go away in just a second. Yep, here we go. Adele, I keep seeing you everywhere. Ooh, what about this? Here we go. Here, check this out.
Yes, I saw that one myself up close and personal. And I don't want to talk about it. Only three more now. Thanks again for the help, by the way.
No problem. Alright, let's go floor by floor, I guess. So this floor. Nothing.